Hi, I'm Rusty Staub. I'm the guy that started this 30 years ago. Our mission was to try to make sure that every time someone dies in the line of duty, these families would actually have not only someone who would help them financially, but that we wanted to make sure they knew we were going to be there and we were going to keep trying to help.
My name is Teresa Jamona. We were blessed with four beautiful daughters.
My name is Pam Madison.
I'm Mike Madison. I'm Brian Madison.
My name's Leslyn Stewart, and I have two daughters.
My husband was Captain Vincent Jamona from Ladder 5 on 6th and Houston Street. He was killed on September 11th, which was his 40th birthday.
He was on 14 years, and he had just been promoted to detective the previous September. He died in February 1983.
Dylan was a police officer in the 7-0 precinct. He wanted to make a difference. He wanted to make a difference not only in his community, but also in the lives of his family.
Well, his nickname in the firehouse was Lieutenant Fun. So he did a lot of crazy things. He would do roll call dressed as Elvis.
I used to say he was your typical American. He loved apple pie, the American flag, the police department, his country, and above all, his family. He had called me at 3:30 and said to me, I'm gonna be late, there's a bomb in McDonald's. And then he said to me before he hung up, so what did you say? And that meant I was supposed to say I love you. But he was a big tough detective with detectives around him, and God forbid he should say that first. So I kind of rolled my eyes and said, I love you. And he said, ditto. And that was the last thing he said to me. He had a massive heart attack at 37.
Dylan worked midnights. I didn't hear my cell ring. And after a while, I got up and realized that there had been a message left on the phone. I spoke with the desk sergeant, and he let me know that Dylan had been shot. And he was going to the hospital.
My friend called me and told me that a plane hit into the tower. I called the firehouse and I got him. And I said, are you coming home? And he's like, no, I can't. He's like, I have to go. And, you know, said, I love you and goodbye. And I didn't think that was gonna be the last I ever spoke to him, and it was.
When someone dies in a line of duty right now, we're like the first line of defense.
And it really is such a breath of fresh air to know that at least the bills are taken care of.
Receiving a check from Answer the Call simplifies things. It makes it one less thing that you have to worry about.
I don't know what it is, but every time that check comes, it's exactly at the time when I'm trying to figure out how to borrow from Peter to pay Paul. It's the end of the summer bills.
I bought the kids laptops. I bought whatever we needed for Christmas.
Dance lessons. Well, Lex used to do karate.
It helps so much. Not only the money part, but just knowing, just a reminder again, that they still care, that they'll always care, that they're just never forgotten.
Answer the Call is a way of letting us know we're not gonna let your family down. Like, we are going to stand by them and we're gonna take care of them.
Never forgetting the officer, the firefighter, never forgetting the surviving families.
The baseball games, I think, were the first thing that
they... Picnics.
Yeah, oh, and the Christmas parties, too.
They're always doing something to keep the kids connected.
There is an officer, there is a firefighter that has paid the ultimate sacrifice, and that they're willing to support that beyond words.
They give us the best situation that we could ever possibly hope for. It's just a rotten situation, and they make it the best that it could possibly be. The absolute best.
I am so proud to be a part of this organization and all the men and women who have made it what it is. And it's truly doing a very special job to the people that actually gave up their lives to make ours better here in this great city of New York. I am thanking you for whatever you do, and we appreciate the fact that you have stood up and answered the call. We need you. Please.